Ready to see the dream garage. Let's take a look inside. Woo! All right, guys. So Brooke and I, you may or may not have known, bought a house recently. And one of the things that came along with the house was redoing this garage, because this thing was a disaster. I'm talking, it leaked, it had holes in the wall. It needed a whole new touch up. And as you guys know, YouTube is our full-time job. So I wanted to make this an efficient, really cool workplace to be able to film videos, do Tackle Tuesdays, and just be able to do our jobs more efficiently. So one reason I wanted to make this video is I'm a first-time homeowner and I needed ideas on how to organize, and you know, I had to do research on products and lighting and flooring and all that stuff. So I wanted to share what I learned with you guys, as well as talk about a lot of cool products that we are either sponsored by or just purchased ourselves that will basically made our dream garage come true. So I will have a lot of stuff linked in the description box below to have it nice and organized if you guys are interested, because there is gonna be a ton of stuff I'm covering in here. So let's get started. As you guys know, fishing YouTubers need a lot of fishing rods. And Brooke and I do so many different types of things, from surf fishing, we go offshore, inshore, land-based, pier fishing, that's what I grew up doing. And with a lot of rods comes a need for a lot of rod storage. And when I got my 50s and my bent butts, I did a big search on the internet, and it was really hard to find bent butt rod racks, which are these guys right here. Because as you guys see, it's awkward. A normal rod rack wouldn't fit that. So I stumbled upon this website called My Real Rack, and this guy makes the most badass rod racks ever. You got standalone ones like this, which have the bent butts, and then you have smaller bent butt rod racks. This is probably my favorite one. I know Brooke likes this one. It swivels like that. I got all my inshore stuff on there. And then this is something we recently installed. This is a vertical rod rack that you can mount on the wall, and he's also got ones for the ceiling. Because I know a lot of people like to, you know, maximize their storage in the garage, people hanging from their garage door. It wasn't really practical for us because we didn't have a lot of ceiling space. But the thing I really like about this is you have two slots per row. So you're not just putting one rod in and wasting the space. And I have a lot of 9-foot rods. This is a really shallow ceiling. So it made, we needed something for the wall, otherwise it would never fit. You got your bridge net hanging on there, and it was super easy to install. Brooke and I just took the measurements, and he sent us some mollies, some screws. We stuck it in through the stucco. By the way, this wall was a disaster. My dad and I actually stuccoed this entire side of the garage. I'll have some kind of pictures playing on the screen here because it looked horrible before. I almost forgot to mention that the My Real Racks actually have vertical rod holders, which you can mount on the wall as well. So they have the horizontal ones, or they have the vertical ones. For us, it worked better to have the horizontal ones. I reached out to him and I set up a coupon code for you guys, because I always like to pass on the savings to my subscribers. So you guys can save $15 off your order if you use my code Landshark, which I'll have linked in the description box below. Check out the website if you guys are in the need for rod storage, because I mean, I've never seen rod racks like this. They're cool, they're made out of starboard. A lot of people keep them outside. You can rinse them off, and I love them. Next thing I want to talk about, since we do a lot of filming, lighting is crucial, as you guys know, for videos. This garage only came with these two little recessed lightings and some really old fixture, and lighting fixtures can be really expensive, and I was not ready to drop a ton of money on lighting. So I found these on Amazon, and what it does is these little fixtures take one bulb and basically creates it into three. So I have a total of 9 bulbs, and then I just got the highest possible lumen LED bulbs I could find out of Home Depot. And I'm pretty sure I have like 15,000 lumens, and it's in one location, but it does radiate out. Like, there's no lack of light in here. And it's gonna be perfect for Tackle Tuesdays. Now I don't have to have a tripod set up with a light stand or anything. So we got the lights. Next thing I wanna talk about is the floor. Brooke and I wanted to make this more of like a cool room. We didn't want it to be a garage. We keep the door closed most of the time let the AC from the house come in here, and we got this really cool epoxy floor. My buddy Chase Yule that I grew up with, he actually does this as a side project down here in South Florida. He services Palm Beach and South Broward. I'll have his stuff linked in the description box below as well. But this stuff is literally indestructible. You could drive forklifts on it, it'll never crack, and it looks so good. It feels good on your feet. And you know how a garage door will get dusty, and it's like no matter how much you sweep it or mop it, it never really feels clean, and concrete is porous? Well, this stuff is not porous. You can sweep it, mop it, and it feels like the inside of your house. It gives your garage it takes it to another level. So we got the garage floor, we got the lighting, the whole garage got a new set of paint. This is where we kind of splurged and treated ourselves in terms of price tag. We got these beautiful, check these things out, garage cabinets. I found this company called New Age, and you know, we didn't want just racks like this over here, because you guys will see in a second why. So over here, we have all of our house stuff. You know, you've got your paint, sealers and stuff like that, some extra tiles that came with the house, extra bulbs, cleaning supplies. And then since we do so much fishing, and fishing is a part of our business, I have a lot of tackle. And this is my pride and joy of the cabinet system. We have all of the tackle organized. But now I went ahead and got all these little tackle boxes. Everything's organized. You got your offshore stuff, inshore stuff, planer stuff, plugs, artificial shrimp, soft plastics, all our lead melting kit stuff down there, lead. So it's nice and organized for now. And
can I say one thing?
Yes.
Another thing about these things is it holds so much weight. The bottom shelf of this has so much weight, and the bottom shelf of that one too, with all the tiles and the paint and stuff.
Yeah.
They can hold a ton of weight, and it doesn't affect it whatsoever. Like, it's not dipping at all or anything like that. It holds a ton of weight.
That's a really good point. Thanks, Brooke. This is steel. This isn't some cheap aluminum. It doesn't flex. Like, there's literally tons of lead down there. And you guys know, these spools are not light either. Like she said, there's paint and tile there. Doesn't flex at all, and it was really easy to assemble. They delivered it right to your door. And by the way, we're not sponsored by New Age. We'd love to be, but we're not. When I find a cool product, I like to share it, because, you know, if someone did a review like this, I would have been that much more convinced to get it. And then, you know, this is also really cool. They sell all different sets, and this guy right here will roll out, and my plan was, you know, we don't have the biggest garage in the world, but what I wanted to do was, when I do the Tackle Tuesdays like I'm telling you guys about, I can get a little bar stool right here, set up the tripod, Brooke can be filming or editing, and I can film videos by myself. It's much more personal, one-on-one. I could have a big area to have lures and leader and tie knots and even lay a fishing rod right here, and it'll just make it so much easier to film videos for you guys. And right above it, we're trying to maximize all of our wall space. Let's put this back real quick. So as I was saying, we're trying to maximize our wall space. And this stuff you guys are probably familiar with. It's in almost every single tackle shop. It's called pegboard. I think I got a giant sheet, like an 8 foot long or longer sheet for $20. You cut it to how you want. I took some 1x2s to make a frame in the back, so to create a space. And then I found some hooks on Amazon. You can get like 200 hooks for $15. We got our hacksaws, some vice grips, tools, just things that you use really often. And then, you know, we have all the Bullbuster braid and the leader. That's another thing. I told you guys I'm going to be dishing out a lot of coupon codes. And why not? You guys want to save money. Bullbuster is a company I've been working with for a long time, probably around 2 years now. They make mono, braid, fluoro, and all that. And you guys can save 10% if you use my code Landshark. And like I said, all of these codes for everything we use is going to be linked in the description box below. Oh, we got our deep freezer.
Oh, I know what to talk about.
What?
We did the...
Oh, yeah.
Insulation.
Okay. We live in Florida, for those of you guys who don't know. Florida is very hot. Now, ACing in a garage is very expensive. So to cool it down, I went ahead and I got this foam. They sell it in a kit, and it fits most one-car garage doors. And you basically, you measure it out in here, you cut it the way you need it. I took all these hurricane braces off, stuck it in there. It's about 1.25 inches thick, and I'll tell you what, it drops the temperature of your garage without any AC or anything at least 5 to 6 degrees, which is huge in Florida.
Probably more, honestly.
You think?
We used to sweat in here, and now it's not bad at all, and we can hang out in, we can actually hang out in here.
Yeah, and it's going to be really nice in the winter because it'll hold all of that cold air in here. And we got the deep freezer over here, which honestly is kind of a shame. It's empty. We have no bait or anything in here. And what else do we got, bro? Oh, we got the castnets in this pile. And then there's some still disorganized stuff because we need to get a shed. We're going to put the bait wells in there, some extra PVC and all that good stuff. And this is a cool product that we actually got. We met this guy at ICAST. I'm sure a lot of people know what this is. It's a collapsible hoop net, which we're gonna use in a future video to catch speedos and ballyhoo with, which I'm really excited about. You know, it's our dream garage. It might not be your dream garage, but I'm very proud of it. And if you guys saw the pictures before, it looked horrible. I mean, this is like a night and day 360 degree difference. How could I forget all these beautiful rods sitting in these rod racks, and I didn't even talk about Conley. So I've been fishing Conley's rods for about close to 2 years now, and they are killing it offshore. Conley's business is rapidly growing, and we have a coupon code set up with him as well. If you guys want to save $10 off any rod, you guys can use my code Landshark, linked below. He literally makes everything you guys could imagine for offshore fishing. Swordfish rods, deep drop, and then also a lot of the inshore stuff. Like Brick and I, we just got back from the West Coast, killer little inshore setups that he has going on. So that'll be linked in the description box below. Now let's move on. Everything, the rod racks, the coolers we use, the knives we use, the line leader, any code we can possibly share with you guys for you guys to save money, I will have it linked in the description box below. So that includes the angle coolers, Dexter knives, the rod racks, all of that, Conley rods. Most of these rods are Conley's. He has a coupon code with me as well. And I think that's it. I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. And if you haven't liked it, what the heck are you doing? Like this video. If you guys made it this far, you probably liked it. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe already. Follow me on Instagram at Landshark Outdoors. All that good stuff. And I will see you guys in that next video.